Doctor, once again, you honor the Caribbean with your presence.
An unavoidable coincidence, I assure you. You came to see Mrs. Emery.
Of course, everybody does. You are just in time. I give you a good table.
We're not here to be entertained. We want to talk to her. Alone.
A chicky chick boom, chick boom. A chicky chick boom, chick boom. Announces you're in the room with the Trinidad Lady. A chicky chick boom, chick boom. A chicky chick boom, chick boom. Your ticker goes boom, boom, boom for the Trinidad Lady.
It's only that I do what I love and love. What I do can't help the mad desire that's deep inside of you. You realize the fault isn't mine, that you are to blame. You want what you can't have, and you're all the same.
A chicka chick boom, chick boom. A chicka chick boom, chick boom. It's dangerous to presume with the Trinidad Lady.
So chalk up one more escapade you never had. The one you dreamed of with the lady from Trinidad.
I do what I love, love what I do. Can't help the mad desire that's deep inside of you. You realize the fault isn't mine, that you are to blame. You want what you can't have, and you're all the same.
A chick a chick boom. Chick boom, a chick a chick boom, chick boom, a chick a chick boom, chick boom. It's the Trinidad Lady.
Why would a man kill himself when he had?
I know all about it. You're lonely. It's wonderful to meet an American girl, and couldn't I have a drink with you after the show? Well, the answer's no. If you're lonely, go home to your wife. This American girl has to make a change.
Oh, but you don't understand.
Oh, but I do. Outside.
Hello. Mr. Anderson of the American Consulate.
Am I being deported or something?
No. We'd just like to have a chat with you.
Well, I don't exactly have time for an international conference, so make it brief.
When did you last see your husband?
This morning at breakfast. Why?
Did you talk to him?
Sure. I asked him to pass me the salt.
Did he tell you where he was going today?
I didn't know he was going anyplace.
Well, he did, and it's rather important that we know where.
I'll think about it. Drop by tomorrow.
I suggest you think about it now. Because if you're trying to protect him...
Protect him from what?
Well, whatever it is, there's no longer any point. He's dead.
How?
Suicide.
I'm terribly sorry, Mrs. Emery.
I'm afraid, if you don't mind, did you hear everything quite clearly, Mr. Wittol?
Believe me, Inspector, I was only trying to help. I said to myself, Chris is in trouble. Maybe I can do something.
Yes, we all know what a great heart you have. I'll have to ask you to come down to headquarters to answer a few questions and make identification. We'll wait outside.